Hey YouTube, it's Teddy. Today, my video is inspired by live streaming, because lately I've been watching a lot of live streams on my computer from other people, and DJs, and music and stuff, and the Crossfader show and stuff like that. So I've kind of come up with my own little setup. I don't actually live stream, so I don't think I'm going to use this, but maybe in the future, not quite sure. But what I've got here is obviously a table. Please ignore the mess. This is my basement. But you got the table, a laptop over here for running, like, virtual DJ or something. Then you could put a MIDI controller here. I do not have one, as you probably already know. Got a mic there. You'd probably want it on a boom stand, though. I just don't have one of those either. But here's a really cool idea. Now, if you've got like a webcam, and see, mine's got one built in here, right there. But if you've got a webcam and you want to point it down at like your mixer, then pretend this is my mixer. This is actually just a little case for the camera, but pretend that's a mixer and it's going right there. Now, up here, I've got my, hold on, better angle, over here. There we go. There's my lighting stand. Now, I only have one of the bottom half, like, side poles on it. So what you can do is, if you took a USB out from here and you ran it all the way over here and then up the stand, you could put a webcam up here and hang it, and then you could point it down here at your MIDI controller. So I just thought that would be a pretty awesome idea, because I know I've seen a lot of people mixing and you actually see what they're doing on the controller. And then, if you wanted to see what they're doing on the software, you just use a desktop capture program, which you can pretty much find anywhere. I did want to mention, though, there's been a lot of people who only use one webcam, as well as two. I mean, there's the people who go all out and have a whole studio, and there's some who don't. But okay, so here's my desktop. Now, on my desktop, this is a program I'm actually using to record this, but this is, hold on, this is backwards, that's what it is. There we go. This is a program called ManyCam. Now, what this does is it actually can switch between many webcams, and you can add still images and a bunch of other stuff and show your desktop. And I mean, yeah, I know a lot of webcam software does stuff like this, but I haven't found much that'll actually switch between webcams. So with this, if you've got like your MIDI controller out on the table and you want to switch to a view of that, and you've got a separate webcam for that, this is what you could do. And you could just say, oh yeah, here's my first webcam, and a second one might show up there, and you just click that one, and then instead it'll switch to that and work out nicely. Whereas normally you'd have to either unplug one and plug one in, or you'd have to just deal with one that you've got and re-angle it, and wouldn't be good. You'd get all those weird noises from the cam's mic. It just wouldn't work. Now, I also recommend, if you're using like virtual DJ or something, and you're streaming this, you're gonna want to use a separate computer, because virtual DJ and all those softwares use up a lot of computer space. So if you're actually streaming this, you're definitely gonna want a separate computer for the stream and one computer for your actual MIDI controlling and stuff. But that's about it for now, I'm pretty sure. But that's what I thought I'd do today, because I was bored, so I thought I'd just set this up. Now, I don't have an extra webcam or anything like that, but I may get one in the future and test out this little setup, see how it works. Because, kind of like the how it might work. So, we'll just have to test that. I also want to get a boom for my mic stand, because at the moment, it just doesn't work. You have to tuck it in next to you, and the weight is really awkward. But, yep. That's it for now, so practice and enjoy.